He's making a list, checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Can somebody please invent new Christmas songs?
No.
I mean, is there a limit? We only have 12? Anyway, I'm tired.
Please read the
show. So Kimberly.
Yeah.
Hey.
12?
There are only 12 Christmas songs. Okay.
12.
You're right.
Six.
Hi, Ainsley.
Are you going to go ahead and do this?
Yeah, so most Americans think Santa Claus is a Democrat. A new survey found that 44% believe the Jolly Man of Heft is of the left versus 28% who think Saint Nick is more like Mitt. It makes sense, at least when it comes to the whole handing out freebies thing. Bob predicted that.
Yeah.
Democrats are the party of giving, except unlike Santa, the giving isn't linked to any worthwhile behavior. Santa rewards you for being good. Liberals reward you for towing the line. Anyway, that's where the similarities end. Santa's toys are made in a workshop, whereas a Dem doesn't make them, he just takes them. Then he spreads them around, but only after melting them down to drab coins. After all, equality of outcome means there's no ceiling on goodness, leaving you with sad trinkets that cost four times more. But hey, in the war of who's naughty or nice, the Dems will always win. They will be Santa and will be Satan, a stereotype perpetrated in pop culture that deems anything rooted in common sense must be mean. And this lets the left run the giveaway. And that's the whole point, to win people over with free crud that in the end isn't really free at all. So yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus. And as that jolly red Democrat flies back to the North Pole, he leaves behind a mountain of toys and a mountain of bills as well. Who's going to pay for those? Let the Republicans worry about that. You know, the grown-ups.